I like
Willem very much.
Tell me, what's a timberman want with being a wiki?
Just looking to earn a living, just like any man. Starting new.
On the run.
I was quite afraid at Cannes of what the reception would be. I mean, you're always afraid to share your work. I'm afraid the first couple pages and give it to my wife. I'm like, oh God, you know, and it is a risk to put yourself out there, as it's a risk for these gentlemen to put themselves out there. And even more than that, like, people seem to understand my intentions, which is like more than you could ask for.
How long have we been on this rock? 5 weeks? 2 days? Help me to recollect.
My brother and I do a lot of research, and I mean, I have like this book this thick, you know, called like Words of the Sea, or, you know, and there is a main author, Sarah Orne Jewett, who would interview sea captains and farmers and things and write in dialect. So it was collecting all this stuff and organizing it. I don't tend to get writer's block because of all the research. I can write garbage for days, but it keeps flowing.
It's got a rhythm, it's got a musicality, and it's a challenge because it's so poetic and has such expressions to play on your mind and accomplish so much, but at the same time, it's elevated, so you have to root it and you have to know exactly why you're saying it. But like all good text, you know, once you jump on it and you jump on it in a pure way, it's like a freight train, it just takes you.
They're quite combative scenes, but they're all very fun. They're not sort of venal. Even when they're really at each other's throats the most, it's still screaming about how the other one can't stop farting and stuff. Yeah. I mean, they're kind of, it's like the highest intensity scenes are always really fun. Even when we're literally fighting each other, that was one of the most fun scenes I've done. I mean, it's absolutely ridiculous, like the whole thing.
We like to talk about how miserable the movie was to make, and it truly was, but I had fun every day.
Yeah,
I did. I had fun every day. It was cold and rainy and shitty and tough, but that's...
It helps you. It helps you. It's a pleasure. And also to wear those costumes. Mm. They're beautifully built costumes. They're beautifully authentic. And you know what? They do sort of keep you warm. Mm. It's miserable.
But
the rain stings, but it puts you there.
Are you going to shoot it in like in LA, you know,
right,
or like against a green screen? No, you know, it's going out to have the elements mistreat you that makes the movie work. There's a lot of challenges for me because like I bit off more than I could chew on purpose, and doing this meticulously crafted camera work with cranes and dollies, like on a spit of rock with demanding scenes. It's a lot. And we were combining three different eras of technology with our camera. So it was constantly breaking down in the rain. And
the visual language is so precise and the camera is so precise. You always got to keep things alive because it's not so much that it gets rehearsed, but in the execution, you're always get many concerns. You're not just concerned with the scene.
So I've got my accent. I've got my leg. And I have to pretend to step over dolly track, and I've got to light my pipe. And you know, I mean, it's like, and I get it. You know, like.
Don't forget the false teeth.
What? The false teeth.
But the joke is, I don't think sometimes people know that I'm wearing false teeth.
I think that it is broadening a mainstream audience's cinematic vocabulary. So, like, I hope that it might give me the opportunity to make one of my own things on a slightly larger scale. Would I want to do, like, Batman? Probably not.
Bullshit.